Most modern martial arts have been really infected these days with too much sport leakage. If I haven't seen it in the ring or haven't seen it in a cage, then that doesn't work. The problem with that is a sweeping generalization that all fights are going to do this because that's the only thing I've seen. There's a lot of danger in that because, once again, violence is not a sport. And the way it starts and the end result of it, all of those things will be much different in real life than sport fighting. Hey guys, Sifu Jason, Greenville Academy of Martial Arts. Thank you for watching. Today's subject is about the eye jab and groin kick. And the genius of Jeet Kune Do is that Bruce Lee got the big things right, which is understanding in self-defense, is that we have to be trying to attack the most vulnerable targets on the enemy efficiently. We can't just think, okay, I have an eye jab guy. I'm just gonna walk out with an eye jab. Because a lot of arts will say, oh yeah, we kick to the groin or we do something like that, but they don't have a system that gets at it. Jeet Kune Do is literally a system of hitting the most vulnerable targets. Now, a couple of things about it. Now, let's walk through this quickly. I'm going to give you a few ideas for training. This strike is the longest strike you have in your arsenal, as far as hand tools go, the eye jab. It disrupts your balance so little, you have almost an Ali jab with it. You can fire it anywhere around the spectrum. Anywhere his face is, you can catch him. This changes the fight. This gives everybody out there stopping power. Everybody's got the ability now to finish a fight or dramatically alter it, just like that. If his head is down or if he's trying to grope his way through, you can kind of rake him. So what I'm doing there is I'm raking. That makes it a lot more accurate. So the eye jab is really that kind of an eye rake there. You see this in some cases, MMA fighters do it by accident, where they just sort of have their hand out and the guy runs into it. So instead of just firing the eye jab, which goes like this, you now have the ability to eye rake. Especially if his head's moving around, you can just continue to have a motion, a slightly downward motion with it. It also protects your fingers from an accidental clash with the forehead and bone. You should do some finger conditioning. We do some finger push-ups in class, and that's generally more than enough. Because again, you're not trying to blow a hole in his head with the eye jab. That's more of an eye gouge when you're in close and you're getting a hold of him and you're able to stabilize the target and really dig your thumbs or fingers in. That's a different story. The eye jab is designed to be quick. And again, I change it to a little bit of raking action in the case where he's kind of trying to move forward like that. You'll get that a lot of people trying to grab you. They're bringing their eyes forward, attack those eyes. Now, the other issue is the groin. Most martial arts are not defending their groin at all anymore. You know, they might have a bit better of a chance to defend their eyes, but the groin and the lead leg are not necessarily defended well at all. So we want to get really good at making sure we add that shot in there. The groin kick is excellent, excellent off an offensive action. Now, Bob has some hands up here, so I might fire the eye jab and then the groin kick. There's another thing to do to train is I can jam a hand and then get that groin kick in there, okay? So if a guy's got a hand for it, I can jam it and then throw a quick kick. And that could cause a hand to come back, it would keep him from punching at me. Anything to kind of lengthen his reaction time. Jamming, checking, hand beats, and any kind of quick offensive action up top, get him to do this, opens him up down low, I got him. Number one, again, remember vulnerable targets. Number two, add your attacks to vulnerable targets to your footwork. You need a system to do that. If you have a system that doesn't support going after those vulnerable targets and defending them, you have a contradiction. You don't have a system. So those systems that go, we tuck the eyes in the groin. Yeah, but they do it sort of like, we can do that, but it's not part of our system. And muscle memory is a fickle thing, guys. Under pressure, you're not gonna rise to the level of your challenge. You're gonna sink to the level of your discipline. Don't forget that. So number one, I wanna make him travel. That's an old way of saying, Driscoll talks about it in his book, I want to make him pick his feet up. So the eye jab is a great tool, but I don't want to just stand here and hope I get them. So I want to be able to move and throw multiple shots. Wherever his face goes, I'm able to fire a quick eye jab, and I can fire them in twos and threes and fours as I'm moving. And, you know, no big deal. I'm not trying to blow a hole in his brain with my fingers yet. I'm trying to rip the eyes. Okay, but again, make sure you make him travel, make him move. And so you move. What I'm doing is I'm sweeping back and forth, right and left. In this case, I'm going to move back one step, right one step, left one step. We call this a basic box. Okay, which what's going to do? I'm going to go back and hit. So what I see somebody did, I went all four major directions. Now, I can do this, I'm gonna do it right side for the camera. All right, I can do a basic where I go over to my right and I go back. Okay, I'm gonna go left, and when I go left, I'm gonna step and then fire and then come forward and fire. Okay, one, two, three, four. So you can get used to moving in all these directions. Everything here is set up, that lead hand, lead foot, to deliver those tools at those targets. I'm gonna repeat this. Everything in Jeet Kune Do is designed to deliver those weapons to these targets. Everything else then becomes kind of incidental. The way to become unlimited with that is through timing and footwork, okay? Be able to move any direction. So I can go back and then groin kick him. I can go left, groin kick, right, groin kick. Oh yeah, I get the eye jab back, okay? I should be able to move in any direction. That's the key, and still be able to fire. Okay, people talk about being unlimited. Unlimited means timing and distance. It doesn't mean out in different arts. You can be unlimited with an eye jab and a groin kick. You can, and conversely, you can be very limited with 10,000 techniques because you're too stationary. Number two, multiply. Fire them in combination. Don't just fire one and stay there. Make sure they're moving, because if you miss once, you hit the second time. Okay? So you stack these shots. You can go upstairs, downstairs, and you can be moving back and forth. That's really important. That helps mitigate the weakness of, especially the eye jab, it has to be really accurate. So again, this is one way to look at it. So you're practicing accuracy. Whether I land clean or not, I'm able to get that shot. Okay? Now the eye jab off that groin kick, right, I might miss right there. I'm hitting him in the forehead, or I hit him in the cheek. All of those things, so I don't have to go, oh crap, I missed him, and give up. No, you want to stack these shots, you can fire him again. So I missed him first time, I can get him second time, okay? So. If you're to be doing Jeet Kune Do for self-defense, and you were to take out everything from the system but these two things, and you could move with it, I'd say you still got pretty good Jeet Kune Do. Because you could stop anybody if you get good at it. And I'm passionate about you being able to defend yourself well. I'm passionate about good people being able to defend themselves against bad people, right? If somebody's coming after you and they outweigh you by 40, 50, 60 pounds, your only chance will be to make sure you're mobile and you're attacking vulnerable targets that aren't going to be dependent upon weight. It's your self-defense. The mindless minions that are all over YouTube land, and I don't mean to be derogatory, but it's a mindless regurgitation of something that sounded wise to them. Jeet Kune Do is about finding your own truth and the whole bit. If self-actualization is the role of philosophy and theology, this is not self-actualization, it's self-defense. Use the direct, most brutal, and clearly, anybody wants to argue with me, you don't think that's going to be effective because you're not seeing it in a cage. There's a reason why they're against the rules, because it makes for very boring fights, because people have to be hyper defensive because they can't block an eye jab with their eyeball. They can't do it. That should be a clue that the most highly conditioned fight combat sport athletes in the world have to have groin protection on against bare feet and accidental kicks, they still need groin protection. And these guys are incredibly well-conditioned athletes. And don't forget the eye jab. That's a clue, right? That you want to depend on something you know will work for you under pressure against any type of opposition. That's the eye jab, the groin kick. And that's why I said this Bruce Lee was a genius, because he didn't major in minors and neither should you when your life is on the line. All right. I want to give special thanks to Bob. He takes so much abuse, man, and he never complains. This day is hard to find people. The unemployment rate is hard to find help. Hopefully this is helpful and hopefully you never need this information. That's a bad day. But if you do need it, it's got to be there to save you, right?